Dr. David Kimbro and Dr. Randall Hughes work to unlock the secrets of the intertidal zone, where the land meets the sea.
Low tide tonight is at 10:15 p.m. Hoping the wind dies down, but if not, then looks like the tide will still drop.
After working as a technician in the Kimbro lab over the last 3 years, Tanya will be starting as a PhD student at Northeastern. For part of her dissertation, Tanya will be studying a worldwide problem on a local scale.
You know, some of the snails are buried, and so I'm trying to kick them up.
The Kimbro lab has revisited surveys conducted by Dr. Robert Payne over 50 years ago. Bay Bar's high diversity of predatory snails makes it a dream site for marine ecologists.
Of the 6 main snail species found on the sandbar in Payne's time, 2 of them are no longer found there, which are these murex snails and two tulips.
The true tulip was a top predator in this ecosystem. Its disappearance is part of a trend that interests Tanya.
There's obviously a worldwide decline in species diversity and particularly of upper trophic levels.
Since Payne's time, there has also been a decline in the area covered by seagrass habitat and a higher number of omnivorous snails. Are these things connected to the disappearance of the tulip?
The experiment I'm doing is essentially to compare the historical assemblage of consumer gastropod species to the current assemblage of gastropod species and how they affect the bivalve community and seagrasses.
These tethered snails will form many ecosystems. There, Tanya can see localized effects on habitat-forming seagrasses and water-filtering clams. The results should help to answer, are more predators better?
In the Grass on the Reef is funded by the National Science Foundation.